This video is on tricking the stupid. I couldn't get the police to take my report. None of them. Couldn't get the FBI to either. Polly Olson from Chapel, Nebraska. She gave me a phone number that I'm supposed to call, and, well, the number that she gave me, I had called previously on multiple occasions. It's the phone number for the Attorney General's office. They sent me to the FBI, who was already ignoring me. So, Polly Olson meant well. However, her number didn't work. It didn't. The Nebraska Attorney General's office sent me to the FBI. Who wouldn't do anything. When I said that the police are terrible to homeless people and that they need somebody in a house to go in with them or the police won't take a report, I meant it. When I said what the police do to people who try to turn in police officers, I meant it. The fact that they did these things that I said that they would do shows that I know what the fuck I'm talking about. A lot of people did not keep their words. They got exposed. They didn't get exposed to make them out to be terrible people. They got exposed to show the fucking situation. They could have come forward. They could have kept their word. Everyone from Danica Garner to Rochelle Shelley Campbell. Hell, even Alicia Bollinger could have come forward and told the truth. These people wanted to play victim. Even after Natalie's death, they were busy playing head games. G-A-M-E-S, denoting that it is entertainment to them. They get off on this shit. Jennifer Farina Bollinger, she's not at the top of my list, but she's pretty high up there. Now, so far as I can tell, if I'm allowed an honest day in court, that woman's looking at 10 to 15 years. Just for starters, some of the conspiracy theories, or conspiracy charges, I should say, could hold maximum of 20 years apiece. Now, if Jennifer Farina Bollinger goes down for conspiracy, that means Officer Amanda Jonas and Officer Brian Valenzuela are all going down with her. It also means that the judges are going down. See, that's the thing about fighting the system. These guys are the ones in control of the evidence. They're the ones that are in control of what gets to get shown in court and what doesn't. And they also have a conflict of interest. The officer who assaulted me in the Longmont Hospital last August should have never had access to me. He was one of the people that I was trying to get and take to court when I went to Joseph Lopez court date. The court date where Natalie's dad threw a tantrum like a 5-year-old. Was calling me a child molester in the courtroom. While I had to remain calm and just take it. While the officers there were hostile towards me and I just had to take it. Officers in multiple states refused to take a report from me before Natalie was killed. Absolutely refused. The fact that I had to go back to those officers is pretty fucked up. Amanda Jonas, because of what she pulled at the Longmont Hospital with her fellow officers made it a conflict of interest for her to even investigate the situation. That didn't stop her from lying outright to me. Now, there's a woman named Alyssa Rainwater. She was a 911 operator when Natalie was killed. Alyssa Rainwater is the one who finally hooked me up with money for the telephone while I was in the jail. Her mom tried to hook me up with money for the telephone my first week there. Those officers did everything in their power to prevent that money from getting to me. Without that money, I wasn't able to get in contact with the people that I needed to get in contact with in order to actually defend myself. I had to just take the abuse in that jail. Fuck the police. There's no such thing as a good cop, because if there were, they'd be arresting the bad cops. But they're not, are they? Most of the decent cops I knew are either dead, they quit, or they were fired. One of the men here, I took a look at his license plate. It's a Wyoming license plate. That means he might be able to help. This man was an officer in the state of Colorado. He is no longer an officer in the state of Colorado because, number one, he doesn't like how people are treated by the Colorado police. Number two, he feels that the M1 hold is abused by officers. Number three, according to him, the officers, he and his fellow officers had a lot of issues with each other because, well, he was a good cop and they weren't. I want to get his story. His name is Jason. He works here at the Starbucks in Cheyenne, Wyoming. A lot of people said that they would do things. And I needed that help. I stuck with those people because I was hoping that they would keep their word. I stuck with Graham, hoping he would keep his word. Repeatedly, he did not. But I stuck with him. Jennifer Dijowski. She lied to me outright repeatedly. But I stuck with her as long as I could. She showed me. She's not interested in the truth. She just wants to tell pretty words. She claimed that she wanted to help me with my castle idea. Now, just so you know, this isn't originally my idea. There are lots of people who have had similar ideas about a co-op or a hippie commune or whatever you want to call it. For people with sensory overload issues. When I say my castle, I mean mine. I mean I get to make the rules. Why? Why can't it be ours? Well, because you people don't know how to get along. What I want to do is get a small piece of property and divvy up portions of it and give them to good people. The way that these things are built, see, we like to destroy ancient technology and pretend like modern day we're so much smarter than these other folks, like the Romans or the Greeks. Or the ancient Chinese or Koreans. Not even close. These people invented mathematics. Invented mathematics. And they gave it to us as a gift. And we pretend like they were stupid for it. Now, you guys want to do this whole blanket thing. The Romans this, the Romans that, the police this, the homeless that. Not every Roman owned a slave. Some Roman slaves were later freed and became slave owners themselves. Then again, slavery in the Roman Empire was different than it is today. See, in the Bible, there's rules about how you're supposed to treat your slave. The Civil War was fought because a bunch of Southerners used the fact that those rules are in the Bible as their reason why it's okay to own another human being. Of course, they didn't follow the rules that are in the Bible, did they? Both the Romans and the Greeks had laws about how you're supposed to treat your slave. First of all, after 10 years of slavery, your slave is no longer a slave. Your slave is no longer your property. Your slave is free, and you owe them 10 years' worth of wages. That's if you're Roman. Both the Romans and the Greeks had festivals. Days of the year where the master became the slave. Where the master was expected to serve his slaves as if he were the slave. Or she. There's a lot of stuff in the ancient world that's complete garbage. Like women not having the right to vote. Then again, in the United States, women didn't have the right to vote either, did they? No, they did not. The state of Wyoming here, first state in the Union to make it legal for women to vote. That's because at the time there was a ratio of 8 to 1. 8 men to every woman in the state. I'm real big on history. I want to know why people do the things that they do. I'm very good at figuring that out. A lot of people are so busy talking, like Shannon Alvarado is probably one of the worst. Just so busy talking, it's always her turn to talk. What she has to say is the most important thing ever. And it's not. It's an interruption, and it prevents her from hearing me. Because she's not listening to understand. She's listening to respond. She's already got her assumptions that I'm not able to work past because she won't stop drinking. I can't make her stop drinking. I can't make her not require attention when she's drunk. I can't force her to sober up. I can't force her to retain any of the information that I need her to retain because she's drunk. When I was there, she wanted some tile work done. Now, this guy Chris was supposed to do the tile work. But 3 nights in a row, he came over to work on her house. And she's talking shit about him to me while he's working on her house. He left all 3 nights. The 3rd night, he told her, you know, your friend there knows how to do the tile work. You should have him do it. And I told her that I would. And then every time I got set up to do it, she needed attention because she was drunk. We're not talking about people who stream, you know, every once in a while. I'm talking about a situation where it's nonstop screaming almost. All right, that's not true. Sally Treon's was nonstop screaming. Shannon Alvarado's was just her yelling at her daughter, which I understand the situation. I understand why Shannon is frustrated, but I also understand why her daughter is frustrated. And I tried explaining that to Shannon. Now, Shannon a lot of people had prepared excuses. By prepared excuses, I mean that they didn't do what they said they were going to do. But then they had excuses that they had prepared for why they didn't, why they wouldn't, why they couldn't. Excuses why they couldn't make an actual effort to actually help. See, Dan Fabert collecting a bunch of information I already collected doesn't do me any good. With Shannon trying to stuff Christine Bouhit's email at me, she's already sent it to me multiple times. I already know, Shannon. Sending me the same thing 400 times. That's not doing me any damn good. Now I gotta go through and find out all of the exact court dates that I was supposed to go to. Before I was arrested in August of last year, I had made it to every single one of my court dates. And every single one of my court dates had been continued. Every one of them. Nothing was resolved. No public pretender was willing to do their job. No police officer was willing to do their job. They did everything in their power to prevent me from being able to speak out in a court of law against them, including having judges who have a conflict of interest presiding over cases that I was not allowed to go to. I was prevented illegally from going to. And even that judge outright lied. What was done to me could have been prevented. What happened to Natalie could have been prevented by people choosing to be adults instead of assault and insult and berate innocent men. I never raped Natalie or Alicia, but I promise you, if Alicia gets raped, I promise you, I will scream at the top of my lungs, the son of a bitch who did it, and I will not stop screaming until the son of a bitch is in prison. Just because I'm pissed off at this stupid cunt doesn't mean that rape is okay. Accusing a man of things that he didn't do is not okay. Alicia Bollinger, you know that your dad is a fucking rapist, you stupid cunt. Go fuck yourself.